So hello everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to the session of PIB 24/7. Main hu Manish Mishra and guys, in today's session I will bring to you as usually five important questions from the PIB news. This session guys is really very important for various government exams like UPSC, RBI Grade B, ASI section. So let's start with the session guys, but before we begin, do subscribe to our channel and press this bell icon, and also you can join this Telegram group for daily quizzes and updated information about the sessions. Okay. And this is a brief information about me. I have done BSc Physics Honours from Delhi University and also have cleared various government exams. And now, let's start with question number 1. The 6th edition of India International Science Festival 2020 has been announced to be held from 22nd to 25th December. So the dates are announced of the India International Science Festival that is to be held from 22nd to 25th December in virtual mode. And guys, remember, this is the first time that it is going to be held in virtual mode. Okay, and the question is, with respect to this IISF, we have to identify the correct statement. Okay, so let us first discuss the news. So this India International Science Festival dates announced ho gayi hai 22 se 25 December 2020. Pehli baar aisa hoga that it will be held in the virtual mode, and also iska jo basic objective hai, that is to promote passion for science among the young student, and also to reflect the role of Indian scientists and science and technology innovation. जो हमारे Indian scientist का role है towards innovation, and also जो हमारी science and technology के innovation है उसको reflect करने के लिए this Indian science film festival will be organized. And why there is a logo of CSIR? So CSIR will lead this event. Okay, CSIR जो है इसका leader होगा, मतलब CSIR जो है वो इस event को organize करेगा with the help of various ministries of government of India and departments. Alright, so remember this, CSIR will lead this event. And can you tell me who is the president of CSIR? मैंने आपको कई बार ये बताया हुआ है, so please write down in the comments. And if we talk about guys, IISF, Indian International Science Festival, so it is an annual event organized jointly by science and technology related ministries and departments of the government of India and Vijnan Bharati. Okay, remember this, Vijnan Bharati is also one of the organizers of India International Science Festival. And it is a festival to celebrate the achievements of India's scientific and technological advancements. जो हमारे science and technological advancement है, innovation है, उसको celebrate करने के लिए this event has been organized and will be organized this year 2020 from 22nd to 25th December. Okay. And पहला और जो second IISF था, first and second IISF were held at New Delhi, third in Chennai, fourth in Lucknow, and fifth in Kolkata. Okay. Last year fifth हुआ था, that was in Kolkata, and the first IISF was held in the year 2015. Okay, पहले दोनों कहाँ पे हुए? New Delhi में, third Chennai, fourth Lucknow, fifth Kolkata, and finally जो sixth था वो कैसा होगा? Virtual mode में होगा. Alright, and इसमें guys, जब ये event हो जाएगा तो इसके बारे में और ज्यादा detail information आएगी कि इस event में क्या क्या चीजें हुई, then we will discuss those things. Okay, right now अभी तक यही information है, so what is the question? We have to identify the correct statement. So Vijnan Bharati is one of the organizers of IISF. Yes, this is also correct, along with the various science and technology related ministries and departments of the government of India. But this year CSIR will lead the event with the help of various ministries and departments. The first edition of IISF was held at Mumbai in 2015. So it was held in 2015, but not in Mumbai, it was in Delhi. Alright, it was in Delhi. Ye kahan pe hua tha? Delhi mein hua tha. So this statement guys is incorrect. And the 6th edition will be led by CSIR. This is absolutely correct. So we have first and third statements as correct statement, which means option A, only 1 and 3 will be the correct answer here. Okay. And now let's move on to the question number 2. So recently a webinar, jiska naam hai Atmanirbhar Bharat, Fostering Steel Usage in Rural Economy, Agriculture, Rural Development, Animal Husbandry and Dairy, Food Processing. Ab dekho, yahan pe jo naam hai, is naam se hi sari cheeze clarify ho jati hain. नाम क्या है? आत्मनिर्भर भारत, फॉस्टरिंग स्टील यूसेज इन रूरल इकोनॉमी, और उसके आगे चार शब्द और हैं, एग्रीकल्चर, रूरल डेवलपमेंट, एनिमल हस्बेंड्री एंड डेयरी, फूड प्रोसेसिंग. सो ये जो वेबिनार था, ये बेसिकली इसलिए ऑर्गेनाइज किया गया था कि ये जो चार सेक्टर्स हैं, कौन से चार? एग्रीकल्चर, रूरल डेवलपमेंट, एनिमल हस्बेंड्री एंड डेयरी एंड फूड प्रोसेसिंग. इन चारों सेक्टर्स का स्टील के ग्रोथ में क्या क्या कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन हो सकता है, और किस तरीके से इन चारों सेक्टर्स का इस्तेमाल किया जा सकता है फॉर प्रमोशन ऑफ द ग्रोथ ऑफ स्टील इंडस्ट्री इन इंडिया. So, इस वजह से इस सेमिनार को का जो पूरा नाम है उसमें चारों शब्दों को लिखा गया है. सो इट वाज ऑर्गेनाइज्ड बाय मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ स्टील इन एसोसिएशन विद डैश, एंड वी हैव टू फिल दिस गैप. ओके, सो गाइस, इट वाज ऑर्गेनाइज्ड बाय मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ स्टील इन एसोसिएशन विद कॉन्फेडरेशन ऑफ इंडियन इंडस्ट्री. So option C here is the correct answer. And if we talk it about more, so it was held to highlight the role of India's steel sector in growth and prosperity of our villages and making our rural economies strong and self-reliant by making our steel industries well. Okay. And ये कुछ announcement, ये कुछ मतलब facts दिए गए थे by the Minister of Steel, Petroleum and Natural Gas, Mr. Dharmendra Pradhan. उन्होंने बताया कि किस तरीके से government ने step लिए गए हैं ताकि जो steel की growth है उसको promote किया जा सके. So the government has started disbursing 1 lakh crore agriculture infrastructure fund. तब agriculture infrastructure fund का steel के growth से क्या relation है? है. So because agriculture में guys कई equipments ऐसे होते हैं. There are various equipments which are made about steel. Okay. So if there is a funding of 1 lakh crore in the agricultural infrastructure fund, then of course, jo steel ka growth hoga, that will be more. Okay. Development of 5000 compressed biogas plant. Again, in the biogas plant, the usage of steel is required. Reserve Bank of India included compressed biogas plants in the private sector, jisse ki unko loan mil sakta hai easily. And the mission to ensure housing for all, investment in rural roads, railway infrastructure augmentation. So in sabhi cheezon mein guys, हमें पता है कि जो स्टील के इक्विपमेंट है उनका इस्तेमाल किया जाता है. सो दैट इज वाई इन सभी स्टेप्स की मदद से जो स्टील की ग्रोथ है उसको बढ़ाया जा सकता है इन आवर कंट्री. ऑलराइट, विद द हेल्प ऑफ ऑल दीज स्टेप्स द ग्रोथ ऑफ स्टील कैन बी प्रमोटेड इन आवर कंट्री. एंड फॉर एग्जाम्पल इफ आई टेल यू की जो एग्रीकल्चर होते हैं, एज आई टोल्ड यू कि जो एग्रीकल्चर होता है उसमें कई सारे इक्विपमेंट्स होते हैं जिसमें स्टील का यूज होता है. तो ऑफकोर्स अगर एग्रीकल्चर इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर फंड गवर्नमेंट प्रोवाइड कराएगी तो ऑफकोर्स जो स्टील का ग्रोथ होगा वो भी बढ़ेगा. जो कंप्रेस बायोगैस प्लांट होता है उसमें भी स्टील का यूज होता है. अदर देन दिस, अगर हाउसिंग फॉर ऑल की बात करें तो ऑफकोर्स घर बनाने में स्टील का प्रयोग होता है. एंड रेलवे इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर में भी ऑफकोर्स स्टील का यूज होगा. ओके, सो हियर द करेक्ट आंसर इज व्हाट, सीआईआई. एंड दिस क्वेश्चन गाइस कैन बी आस्क्ड इन द वन मार्कर्स ऑफ ईएसआई सेक्शन. ओके, ये वन मार्कर क्वेश्चन हो सकता है. And now let's talk about the question number 3. This is guys a very important question. This can be asked in your exam. Which of the following is not one of the institutes which have been recommended by Ministry of Finance for disengagement from MOEFCC? जो Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change है उसके अंदर काफी सारी autonomous institutes हैं जो कि काम करती हैं under the Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change. But recently Ministry of Finance under the General Financial Rules. Alright, under the General Financial Rules, इसका एक section है जिसके अंदर autonomous institutes की बात की जाती है. So under this rule, Ministry of Finance has disengaged 5 autonomous institutions from the Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change. So the question is, which of the following is not one of those institutes? Okay. So let's discuss the news. So Ministry of Finance has recommended the disengagement of 5 autonomous institutions under the Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change and merger of 2 institutes. दो institutes की merger की बात भी की गई है, right? And this has been done under the General Financial Rules, as I told you. And these are the 5 institutes that have been disengaged from the Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change. And what are these? Wildlife Institute of India, which is located in Dehradun, we all know. Indian Institute of Forest Management, Bhopal. Indian Plywood Industries Research and Training Institute, Bangalore. CPR Environmental Education Center, which is in Chennai, and Center for Environmental Education, Ahmedabad. So you have to remember the name of all of these 5 institutes, alright? And if you talk about the merger, so which 2 institutes are merging? The Society of Integrated Coastal Management, which is located in Delhi, and National Center for Sustainable Coastal Management, which is located in Chennai. So these 2 institutes are merging, and these 2 institutes are recommended to get merged, okay? अभी ये मर्ज हुए नहीं है, इनको रिकमेंड किया गया है कि इनको मर्ज कर दिया जाएगा. और इनको मर्ज इसलिए किया जा रहा है बिकॉज दोनों का जो फंक्शन है वो सेम है. बोथ ऑफ देम परफॉर्म द सिमिलर फंक्शन, दैट इज व्हाई इट इज रिकमेंडेड टू मर्ज दीज 2 इंस्टीट्यूशंस. ऑलराइट, एंड व्हाट विल बी द इफेक्ट ऑफ डिसएंगेजमेंट ऑन द इंस्टीट्यूशंस गाइस. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल जो गवर्नमेंट का सपोर्ट है दैट विल बी फेज्ड आउट इन अ टाइम आउट मैनर. गवर्नमेंट का सपोर्ट हट जाएगा. So, अगर गवर्नमेंट का सपोर्ट हट जाएगा दैट मीन्स जो बजट रिडक्शन है वो होने लगेगा. सो ग्रेजुअली अगले 3 सालों में हर साल 25% का जो बजट है वो रिड्यूस होता रहेगा. ओके, ग्रेजुअल बजट रिडक्शन ऑफ 25% ईच ईयर फॉर अ पीरियड ऑफ 3 इयर्स एंड डिसोसिएशन ऑफ द गवर्नमेंट फ्रॉम मैनेजमेंट ऑफ द इंस्टीट्यूशंस. ओके, अब इससे नुकसान ये है कि जो इंस्टीट्यूट्स हैं उनका बेसिकली काम है रिसर्च का, पढ़ाने का, ये सारा काम है. ओके, बट जब उनकी फंडिंग खत्म हो जाएगी तो उनका जो पूरा का पूरा फोकस है वो फंडिंग की तरफ चला जाएगा. देन जो उनका रिसर्च की तरफ फोकस था वो कम हो जाएगा. दैट इज द मेन क्रिटिसिज्म जो कि इस स्टेप को दिया गया है. So it will make institution worry for the financial issues, thereby deviating them from their prime focus of research and development. And this step is seen as a first step towards sending these institutions in the hands of private players. Private players ke paas jaane ka bahut zyada chances hoga, because of course अगर एकदम से किसी इंस्टीट्यूट की फंडिंग छीन ली जाएगी तो वो पैसा कहां से लाएंगे? ऑफ कोर्स तो उनको प्राइवेट प्लेयर्स के पास जाना ही पड़ेगा, दैट विल बी देयर मजबूरी. ओके, सो दिस वाज दिस न्यूज एंड नाउ लेट्स कम टू द क्वेश्चन. सो व्हिच ऑफ दिस व्हिच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग इज नॉट वन ऑफ दैट इंस्टीट्यूट? सो वाइल्ड लाइफ इंस्टीट्यूट इंडिया, इट इज देयर. इंडियन इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ फॉरेस्ट मैनेजमेंट इज देयर. सेंटर फॉर एनवायरमेंटल एजुकेशन अहमदाबाद इज ऑल्सो देयर. सीपीआर एनवायरमेंटल एजुकेशन सेंटर, ऑल ऑफ दीज आर देयर. National Center for Sustainable Coastal Management, this is the institute that is going to be merged. So this is not one of that institute that are going to be disengaged. So option E will be the correct answer, right? Option E will be the correct answer. And now the question number 4. With respect to the International Migration Outlook 2020 that was published by Organization for Economic Cooperation and Development, OECD, identify the incorrect statement. So we have to identify the incorrect statement regarding this International Migration Outlook 2020 that was published by OECD. Okay. So this report, guys, measures what? The inflow of migrants to the OECD countries in 2018. And which are these OECD countries? So these are 37 in number. There are 37 OECD countries, and 2018 mein kitne total inflow migrants hue to the OECD countries? This report measures that. Okay, and this was the 44th edition. Do also remember this. And now let's talk about the key highlights from the reports. That is very important because isme India ka bhi naam aaya hai kafi zyada. So this is very important. So the total inflow of migrants to OECD countries stood at 66 lakh, and this has been increased by 3.8% over the previous year. पिछले साल से यानी कि 2017 से कितना बढ़ गया? 3.8%. And this data, guys, is of the year 2018. Remember this. This data is of the year 2018, all right. And China bagged the top spot in the report. Aur China ki taraf se 4.3 lakh Chinese people aise the jinka migration hua to the OECD countries in the year 2018, and which was approximately 6.5% of the total migration. Okay. And if you talk about India, so India emerged as the second largest source country, both in the terms of inflow of migrants and the Indians taking citizenship of those OECD countries. Okay. मतलब सबसे ज्यादा जो इनफ्लो था माइग्रेंट का उसमें इंडिया नंबर सेकंड पे था, एंड ऑल्सो जो इंडियन सिटीजंस वहां की सिटीजनशिप अक्वायर कर रहे थे उसमें भी इंडिया नंबर 2 पे था. ओके, नंबर 3 पे इट वाज रोमानिया. एंड द टॉप 4 कंट्रीज वेयर इंडियन चूज टू बिकम सिटीजंस आर यूएस, कनाडा, ऑस्ट्रेलिया एंड यूके. इन चारों कंट्रीज में इंडिया के जो लोग हैं उनको सिटीजनशिप अक्वायर करने की जो वो है, जो उन्होंने चूज किया to become citizens of these 4 countries preferably. Okay, number 1 pet is US, then Canada, then Australia, and then UK. Okay, and what is the effect of COVID-19 on the migration? So according to this report, guys, because of COVID-19, visa issuances mein kafi zyada issue tha, jiski wajah se jo migration hai usme kafi zyada migration kafi zyada kam hua hai, and 46% in the first half of 2020 as compared to the same period of the 2019, and in the second quarter the drop was 72%. पहले हाफ में 46% का ड्रॉप था, फर्स्ट क्वार्टर में, दिस शुड बी फर्स्ट क्वार्टर में इट वाज 46% का ड्रॉप, एंड इन द सेकंड क्वार्टर इट वाज 72% का ड्रॉप. ओके, सो दिस वाज अबाउट दिस न्यूज, गाइस, एंड नाउ लेट्स कम टू द क्वेश्चन. वी हैव टू फाइंड द इनकरेक्ट स्टेटमेंट, एंड इफ वी टॉक अबाउट ओईसीडी, सो इट वाज एस्टैब्लिश्ड इन 1961, इट इज हेडक्वार्टर्ड इन पेरिस, एंड सेक्रेटरी जनरल इज एंजेल गुरिया. Alright, Angel Gurria is the Secretary General. So the total inflow of migrants to OECD countries stood at 96 lakh. So is it 96 lakh? No, it is 66 lakh. Okay, so this statement is incorrect. India bagged the top spot with 4.3 lakh Indians migrated to OECD countries. Is it India? No, guys, it is China. So this statement is also incorrect. And the top 4 countries where Indians choose to become citizens are US, Canada, Australia, and UK. Yes, this is absolutely correct. So we have to find the incorrect statement, which means option B. Only 1 and 2 will be the correct answer here. Okay. And now let's move on to the last question for the day. And this is based on the static part of the ESI. So let's talk about this question. And this question is talking about the Monetary Policy Committee of RBI. I hope aapne sabne iske bare mein suna hai. So let us first discuss about this Monetary Policy Committee. So guys, Monetary Policy Committee is constituted under the Section 45ZB. Okay, remember the section. Section 45ZB of the RBI Act 1934. Okay, RBI Act 1934. It constitutes of 6 members. इसमें total कितने members होते हैं? 6 members होते हैं. 3 from RBI and 3 nominated by the central government. ठीक है, 3 nominated by the central government, 3 from the RBI. Monetary Policy Committee guys, ex officio chairperson is governor of RBI. Okay, and इसके अलावा जो इसके functions होते हैं, that is to decide the policy rates like reverse repo rate, bank rate, etc. Right? And जो persons that are nominated from the central government side, उनका जो tenure होता है, that is 4 years. Okay? 4 years उनका tenure होता है, and ex officio governor is RBI. And can you tell me the newly appointed deputy governor in the RBI? Write down in the comments the newly appointed deputy governor in the RBI. So there are 4 deputy governor in the RBI. So please write down the in the comments the name of newly appointed deputy governor. And also recently central government ne 3 jo members hain from the central government side unko appoint kiya tha. One is Shashank Bhide. Let me tell you the name of them. One is Shashank Bhide. And Shashank Bhide, then we have there is some Verma. I am forgetting the name, guys. There is some Verma, and one is I'll tell you in the next session. Shashank Bhide was one, there is one Verma, and one I'm forgetting right now. So I'll tell you in the next session, all right. So this is about guys the Monetary Policy Committee, and now let's talk about the question. So we have to identify the correct statement. So it is constituted under the Section 45ZB of RBI Act 1934. Yes, this is absolutely correct. It has 6 members, all nominated by the Government of India. No, all are not nominated by the Government of India. Out of 6, there are 3 persons which are nominated by the Government of India, and the members of committee are appointed for 5 years. No, these are appointed for 4 years. Okay. So we have only one statement correct here. So only one option C will be the correct answer. Okay. So guys, that's it for the session today. I hope आपको ये session अच्छा लगा. I will tell you the name of 3 newly appointed persons in the Monetary Policy Committee in the next session definitely. Thank you so much for watching. मिलते हैं कल के session में. Goodbye. Take care and God bless.